No one forgets their first encounter with a frog, salamander, turtle, or the sound of a frog chorus heralding the first days of spring. These events mark places and seasons in our minds, connecting us to nature and revealing how we fit into the larger world. They can be life-changing. Sadly, many of these animals are disappearing, and a major threat to their survival is infectious diseases. Ranavirus is one of the leading causes of amphibian population declines around the world. Turtles, snakes, and fish are also susceptible to ranavirus. Once infected, animals can experience severe internal bleeding and rapid death. In fact, scientific evidence shows that populations of species sensitive to these viral infections could go extinct within just a few years. How does ranavirus spread to amphibians and reptiles? People can unknowingly carry the virus, which can attach to skin, boots, clothes, equipment, vehicles, and recreational gear from a wetland with the disease to another without it. Once introduced, the virus can spread quickly. Frogs, toads, and salamanders with ranavirus can develop skin lesions, blood spots, and swollen abdomens. Infected turtles will often have a runny nose, swollen neck, and white plaques inside the mouth. Diseased animals may act lethargic, move erratically, or fail to react when threatened. However, not all animals carrying ranavirus will display symptoms.
Using these simple steps before and after you enter a wetland, you can help stop the spread of ranavirus and other pathogens like the chytrid fungus BD. To begin, set up your cleaning station at least 150 feet away from any wetland or other body of water to avoid contaminating them with bleach. Then, remove all mud and dirt from boots and gear. And rinse them with clean water. Soak or spray them in a solution of 3% bleach, or a half a cup of household bleach in 1 gallon of cold water. Leave this on for 5 minutes. Finish by rinsing everything well with clean water. Another species of chytrid fungus, bee sal, has decimated salamander populations in Europe. Bee sal has not yet been detected in the Americas, but its disinfection requires a stronger bleach solution than is needed for ranavirus and BD. If bee sal exposure is a concern, disinfect your equipment with a 20% bleach solution or 4 cups of household bleach mixed into 1 gallon of cold water. Please remember, bleach solutions lose their potency over time, so dispose of any bleach solution that's more than 5 days old.
At a minimum, for larger equipment and gear, pressure wash and allow to air dry. Remember, brush, rinse, bleach, and rinse. By doing these simple measures, you will do your part to protect our amazing wildlife.
To learn about alternative disinfectants to bleach, mixing appropriate volumes of disinfectant, or more on amphibian disease, please go to our website.